we're going to get to know a little bit more about the guys. We're going to play a game called Who's Most Likely To?
Okay.
Right. So it goes like this. I just ask you a question. Who's most likely to do whatever? You guys hold up the name of who it is, okay?
All right.
Done deal.
Who's most likely to hold the door open for a lady?
Give myself that one.
Can I put all four of us?
Oh,
I
think yeah, we're all pretty gentlemen.
We're all pretty. Yeah, that's not fair. Yeah,
yeah, no, yeah, that's fair.
Yeah. Is that totally against the rules?
No, gentlemen. It totally works. It totally works.
Hey guys, guess what? Chivalry is not dead.
There you go. It lives right here.
It lives on with big time with these four fine young, good-looking gentlemen.
And on that note, who was most likely to spend the most time on their hair in the morning?
Well, let me just get a. This one out.
Hey.
Oh, unanimous.
Look, I'm usually late, but I just like to say I'm fashionably late. Just very fashionable.
Yeah, like fashionably hours late.
Late.
A lot.
So, yeah.
Woo!
No one?
At
okay.
least he mans up to it.
Yeah, right.
Who is most likely to remember to call their mother on her birthday?
You know what? I'm going to go ahead and go with me since I did remember that recently.
Good for you.
Give it to
yeah, you should all say yourselves.
Like, you know what? We're all big family people.
Yeah, we're cute. I don't know. Let's
No, I look bad. I'm giving it to you, man.
I called my, I mean, I for sure called my mom and my dad on the birthday.
Yeah, I called Logan's mom.
Hey, no, we love our families. We love our families, honestly. So they're like our biggest support system. So cool. We love them.
Who is most likely to bring an animal along with them on tour?
Well,
do one of these.
How about that?
Yeah,
I'm gonna go with that.
Have good dogs.
Carlos and I both brought our dogs on tour. I've got my little dog Fox,
and I've got my big dog Sydney.
By the way, which I have to admit, like I would never have brought a dog on tour, and I'm glad that they did because I get to enjoy the fruits of their labor.
Exactly.
Like they have to walk the dog, they have to feed the dog and give the dog water. I just get to play with the dog.
Listen, Kendall did just get a pig, so I'm hoping that he brings his pig one day on tour.
I would love to.
It's a pygmy pig, which is interesting because you have to say pig twice.
No, it's actually a micro pig.
Oh, micro.
Sorry.
I like pygmy.
Micro pig. Very cute though.
Who is most likely to be late because they're just playing video games?
Oh. Get out of here. I was going to say all of us.
Always playing video games.
That's tough.
He's the electronic guy. He's the electronic guy.
I was going to say all of us.
No, Carlos wouldn't be playing the video game. He'd be trying to make the video game work.
Carlos, you were late for rehearsal the other day because you were playing video games.
Exactly.
You. And that's right. Yes. I definitely was.
All right, guys. Would you mind if we take some questions from the audience right now?
Let's do it.
Yes.
All right. We got one over here.
What's your guys' favorite color?
I'm going to say green, but then in parentheses, I don't know if it's an actual color, silver. Like silver.
I qualify that as a color.
I dig it.
Yeah.
I think gray is a shade, but silver's
yeah.
a color.
Yeah, okay.
Silver's like a very fancy color.
Yeah.
You know what? Green's always been my favorite color as well.
I like the color red.
Passion.
Yes.
I'm going to go with purple.
So if red, hold on, if red is passion, then what's purple?
Purple is
royal passion.
That is royalness.
Royal passion.
We got another question over here.
How long do you guys practice for? Like every week or something?
I feel like all day, every day.
Oh, man. Well, definitely.
For the tour.
Tour, we had a month to prepare, but we spent 10 days going to Europe. So really about 3 weeks we prepared for the tour, which is funny because we have, about 15 songs. Whereas our first song we ever did took us about a full week just for one song.
For one
song.
Right.
We've gotten
We're
a little more
better.
Efficient.
Yeah.
What is your favorite song to perform?
Ooh.
Favorite song to perform?
For me, it's probably Show Me.
Show Me is a good time.
A lot of fun, yeah.
Till I Forget About You, the crowd goes crazy until I forget about you, so it's always a blast.
Time of Our Life, I really love the choreography for that, and it's a really fun song, party song, so I like that one.
Love Me for me, because there's a lot of, like, cryo, it's called, like, these big, like, jets of, like what?
It looks like
smoke.
Steam,
or smoke, yeah.
Smoke stuff, it's a lot of fun, it looks cool.
Now, what I love about the way you guys communicate with your fans is that you're like right in there with them, whether it's Twitter, whatever it is online.
Or right here.
Right here in the audience and in front of you. What do you guys get back from your fans that energizes you or that makes you want to keep doing what you're doing?
Our fans are a special breed, and they really like, they support us no matter what we do. Every song that comes out, every thing on television that we do, they're always watching it and they're always supporting it. So we like to think that we have the best fans in the world. And because of that, we always try to make it a point to share ourselves with them beyond just putting out a song or putting out a TV show. Like last night I went out at the very end of the show, we were just about to leave, and I just went and talked to like 30 girls that were standing on the other side of the fence and just you know, there was like, you know, how, what did you think about the show? What was your favorite performance in the live show? And they're like, oh, I love this one. I love this one. Oh, thanks for coming to talk to us. We really appreciate it. And it's like, we're all the same people. We just happen to have really cool jobs.
That's what's been really unique about the TV show. It's letting all of our fans see how we're growing as a group, literally as it's happening in real life.
Yeah.
And so we like to keep that same connection, you know, that like one-on-one basis with our fans. Because, I mean, they've seen us straight from the beginning. From when we auditioned in the show to actually...
I think they've even seen the audition tape.
Yeah.
There was a special that we had where they showed our audition tapes, and I was like...
Whether we wanted them to do it or not, they did it.
I don't know if I'm okay with that.
But really, the best feedback in the world, our fans are honest, too. They'll be like, yeah, I didn't love that part, but I love this part. But, I mean, seriously, when we talk to them, we get to make our show better and our music better.
Awesome. We love them to death, and we're so thankful for them.
All right, guys, when we come back, we wrap it up here with Big Time Rush with one more performance. Stick around. Big Time Rush. We've had a great time with the guys so far today, and it's only gonna get about 1,000 times better. Performing a special acoustic version of their smash single, The Music Sounds Better With You, here is Big Time Rush.
One, two, three, four. Better with you. Better with you. Yeah. I tried to write this down. The words just don't come out. It's hard to say how you feel.
You feel.
Been down the longest road. Said yes when I'm a no. I lost control of the wheel.
Cause you know that things get so bad. You've got my back. Make me wanna sing. And girl, I'm singing about you.
No sweeter sound than what I found. No perfect love
could be more perfect than I.
Ooh, baby.
Feels like
the music sounds better with you, baby. It feels right. Everything's better with you.
I used to think that love was something fools made up. Cause all I knew was heartbreak. Oh, I couldn't help myself. Let this all go through. There's only so much a heart can take.
So bad, you've got my back. Make me wanna sing, and girl, I'm singing about you.
No sweeter sound than what I found. No perfect love
could be more perfect than mine.
Ooh, baby,
it feels like
the music sounds better with you, baby. It feels right.
Everything's better with you.
Every song, every rhyme, every word is better with you.
Every day,
all of the time,
all of the time.
Everything,
the music sounds better with you.
She's my music enhancer. When the music plays, she's my dancer. When I'm around her, everything's faster. For every question I have, she's the answer. Man over heels, can't explain, she's so surreal. When I'm around you, baby, you make me feel like
everything's better with you.
Ooh, baby, it feels like,
it feels like
the music sounds better with you, baby. It feels right. Everything's better with you.
Ooh, baby, it feels like.
There we go. Thank you, guys. Thank you, guys.
All right. Another great performance here from Big Time Rush. Guys, the song sounds so great in this small, like, acoustic setting. It must feel so much different when you're performing it for a huge crowd with all your special effects and all that background music. How does it feel different for you guys when you're performing it like this?
It's much more intimate. And I honestly like it a lot better, so I can see everybody and see all the fans singing all the songs and all the words. It's amazing.
It sounds like more of a campfire vibe. And so that's fun.
Getting to play guitar is like my favorite thing to do on my off time. So playing guitar on TV is pretty cool too.
Don't get me wrong. Being in arenas like Air Canada is amazing. But you know what? Being this close to the fans is the best thing in the world.
I'm sure they feel the exact same way. They must totally love it. Well, Carlos, Logan, James, Kendall, thank you so much for hanging out with us for our one-to-one Big Time Rush special. Do you have anything else that you'd love to say to all your fans in Canada?
Much love to all the fans.
We love you guys. You're the best in the world. Thank you. Yeah.
We'll Canadian you rushers rule.
All right, everybody. Check out the album Elevate and make sure to watch Big Time Rush right here on YTV. Give it up to them, guys.
Thank you, guys.